So I was telling you about shortcuts. Okay. Last time I was telling you about shortcuts, that how to deal shortcuts in Excel. So in Excel, some of the shortcuts you can see just by pointing your mouse to any of the option. So in a screen tick, it will show the option. When you point your cursor to any of the ribbon options, if there is any option, any shortcut available, it will show in screen tip. But there are a lot of options which don't have shortcuts. So there is an alternate way for doing that. For that, we press Alt key from our keyboard. We press it once. When we press Alt key, then you can see on your home tab or on your tabs, there are some keyword visible in your screen. So you can see that on home tab it is H. For insert tab it is N. Page layout P. So these are some keywords which you need to follow for activating an option. So let's suppose if I want to draw borders on any selected area, so I need to go into home tab and to select border option, and there will be a drop down list, and from that I will select all borders. So it will draw borders around your selected area. But if you want to do it with shortcuts, so you need to press Alt one time. We need to go in home option. So we need to press H, as the option is appearing H. So when I press H on the tab, there are lot of more keywords appearing. Such as we can see for borders we have B. And when you press B, the drop down opens and the other options are visible. So we can see for all borders we have A. So we can press A. So basically for the shortcut for drawing all borders, it is Alt HBA. Because it is in keyboard, you can do it very fast. So it will follow all the options and do it the same. Okay, very quickly. Like that, you want to merge some area. So you need to select the area. You need to press Alt key, and when your options are visible, it is under home tab, you need to press H. And then for merge in center, you have it is showing me the option M. So when I press M, there is another drop down, so we can see the options. On margin center we have keyword C as visible in the screen. So when we press C, the value will be merged. So we got to know two keywords here. One for drawing borders, Alt HBA, and one for merging, Alt HMC. Likewise, we can apply lot of shortcuts, lot of options with shortcuts, such as if I want to apply filters somewhere, I need to select the area, and there are filters in home tab, in sort and filter we have, and we have filter. So if I move my mouse to filter, so it shows me the screen shift, control shift L. By control shift L, I can also put filters. But with shortcut, how will I do it? That I will press Alt. Then on home tab, it is H. Then for sorting and filter option, it is showing me S. So when I press S, and then it is showing me drop down. And for filter I have F. So the shortcut for filter is Alt-HSF. For applying and unapplying, it is Alt-HSF. Same here in data, we have filters in data tab also. So for data, when we press Alt, it shows me A. So Alt A, and for filters it is showing me T. So when I press T, it applies filter. So we have another shortcut, Alt A T, for applying and unapplying filter. Is it clear, ma'am?
Yeah.
So we have, likewise, we can do with any of the options in the ribbon. We can apply shortcuts with it, with the help of Alt button. When we press Alt button, if you want to go in Office button, so there is also a keyword as F. So when you press F, there is a whole list you can see. So you can apply any of the option from that. Okay. So by this way, you can apply shortcuts in Excel. So there are one more type of shortcuts, that how to deal with dialog boxes, such as you have dialog boxes, dialog box in paste special. Like this, you have paste special, so it is called a dialog box. So here we have different approach to apply, to select these options, these buttons and radio buttons. Let's see how to do deal with these dialog boxes. When you press Control 1 from your keyboard, there is a format cell dialog box. So you can see there are tabs in format cell option: number tab, alignment tab, font, border, fill, protection. So moving through the tabs, we use Control tab. While pressing the Control button, the Control button will be pressed and we press tab one by one. So it will shift the tab. Okay. When you press Control tab, it moves ahead. Let's suppose you want to go back side, you want to go back, you want to return in the previous tab, so you need to press Control Shift both and then press tab one by one. So it will do in reverse order. Okay. Let's say I want to work on this alignment tab. So alignment tab, we have text alignment, a lot of options are here. So with shortcuts, I need to select this horizontal is center. Center I need to select from shortcut. So here is another way for shortcut. So you can see there is written horizontal, vertical, these options are available. And you can see there is a small underlined character. Underlined character is available on every option. That means you have a shortcut with Alt key here, but you need to press Alt key. While pressing Alt key, with Alt key, the Alt key will be pressed and you will press the keyword. Such as I need to go in horizontal option. So I need to press Alt key, it will be pressed, and the underlined character is H. So when I press H, the drop down opens. Okay. How to navigate between the inside this drop down? You can use your arrow keys or you can press the first character of the option. Like if I want to use center, so I can press C, and if I press again C, so it will go to second option for C. Okay, so it will toggle between these, the available option, the character starting with C. Okay, for selecting this value you can press enter, so this value will be selected. Now I want to do wrap text here. So for wrap text, we can see the W is underlined character for this. So we will press Alt E and we will press this W. So it will activate this wrap text option. So you can see. Okay. That's how we do it. Then, yes,
one. Huh? You want enter in font section, we have to do
Ctrl
arrow.
What are you saying, ma'am?
You want to go to font.
You want to go to font, so then you need to press Ctrl and then tab one by one. So you will be toggled in these tabs.
Okay, then we want to enter into font option. You have to press Alt.
Yes, you need to keep pressed Alt key and select this, press the underline character.
Okay.
There is a big underline character. Okay, if you want to go in font style, you need to, you can see there is O underline. So you need to press Alt O. So you are activating it. Okay.
Then we need to use arrow keys,
right? Yes, we can use arrow keys. Or the first letter, like I'm typing B. Oh, it is not taking because it is a text box. So you can use arrow keys here. Okay. Or you can type. Now, for OK, so let's suppose I want to press OK. So you can see there is a green area around OK. That means this button is activated on enter button. When you press enter, it will press OK. When you press escape, it will press cancel. Okay. So you can see the activated button by its green area. When you press enter, which button is going to press, you can see by judge by that, at whichever which button is green. Okay, when you press OK, cancel, then escape button, ESC. So I want to set it OK, so I will press enter button. So the settings will be applied on this option. Okay. So likewise for printed screen we go Alt F O V. Print preview. In Excel 2007 it is Alt F W V. In Excel 2010 and 2013 it is Alt F W, like this. So we have options like this is also a dialog box for page setup. So you can easily set the page here. Like I want to do landscape, so I will press Alt L. Okay, I want to fit to page by one, so I will press Alt F. Then press OK, so I know there is enter. So the page area will be set. Then escape for escaping. From there to return to back to normal screen. So that's how some options we use for shortcuts. Okay, now you want a complete list of shortcuts. Okay, so from where you will get it, you just press F1 from your keyboard.
Okay.
and type, the help option will open here. You can type keyboard shortcut.
Okay.
And press enter. So Excel shortcut and function key. The first option is here. You can maximize it. So you can see there is a complete list of shortcuts here. So you can easily go through with this, that control shift, this 9 or forward bracket. So there are a lot of shortcuts with control shift, with control, and to just refresh your shortcuts knowledge. So we have a complete list of that. Okay. So just keep practicing about these shortcuts, because people judge your excellence by your speed, and you can excel your speed by keep shortcuts. So now let's move to one more thing. If you want to know the Windows shortcuts, so there is a thing, because we have upgraded to new Windows system. Every now and then we have new Windows version launch, so there are a lot of upgradation in shortcuts also. So the same thing you need to do, keyboard shortcuts, search the keyboard shortcuts and refresh that knowledge also. You'll find the keyboard shortcuts here. So there are a lot of new shortcuts you can see. Okay. All types of shortcuts, dialog box shortcuts, which I told you. Okay. Window logo key have n numbers of shortcuts now. Earlier it was window D only. Okay. There are a lot of new shortcuts here. So you need to be updated about it. Okay. Now let's return to Excel. In Excel, one more thing is important. We need to know that while working on Excel, we need to know the limitation of Excel also. What are the limits of Excel, limits of and specification. So just for reference, because when you are trapped in any interview and the people don't know about Excel much, so they ask some silly questions to you, that how much rows are in Excel, how much columns are in Excel, these type of questions people ask. So these type of information from where you get, you can search, press F1 again, and you can type the limits. Okay. So Excel is specification and limits option opens here. So when you click on that, you get a complete specification about this Excel. Okay. So in such as that, how many workbook you can open. So it is depending about your RAM. What will be the worksheet size? How many can be the column width maximum, row height, and likewise the useful information is here, like in filter drop down list, how many maximum values we can store. It is 10,000. How many unique cell formats we can use, 64,000. So likewise we have some limits and specification which we need to take a reference in our mind, that where we going to find it. It will be helpful when you will be learning VBA, because in VBA you do all with programming, so you don't limit yourself to Excel. So you have to be limited that time when you are programming on VBA. So this sheet will be like a reference to you, that if any problem is occurring, so we need to check first. Okay, so these are there are some information. Okay. So now, let's go for customization of it. So we have office button here. When we click office button, we have option Excel option. So in Excel option, when you click it, there are this type of dialog box opens. So there are several options to check and check here, which makes sometimes troubles you when you don't know it. Like when I am typing any text here and selecting it, so memory toolbar. Most of the people don't use this memory toolbar, but for that who use, sometimes it is not appearing. So here can we appear it again? It was under Excel option. In popular tab, you have first option show mini toolbar on selection. Yes, ma'am.
Not clear.
Huh? Just tell me when it returned to Excel.
I'm not.
So I was saying that there is there is another option called live preview. What is live preview? When you want to change any color of Excel, and before selecting the color option, it shows you the preview that how will it look like. Okay, so that option sometimes not appear when your popular option is unchecked, this enable live preview. When this option is unchecked, that live preview will not appear. Okay, so you can resolve this error from that. And one more thing you are seeing in my screen, that there is an developer toolbar. Are you able to see developer toolbar?
Yeah.
So this developer toolbar helps you to program in VBA. So you have option here in Excel options. In popular tab, you have show developer toolbar, developer tab in ribbon. So it is unchecked at your end. When you check it, you will get the developer toolbar. Okay. So in 2010 and 2013, this option is which version you are using exactly? 2013, I guess. Hello.
Yeah, 2013.
So this option is under, I guess, it's customize. This option is under customize. So all the option will be there, but they may be in another tab. Okay, so you need to check for it. There are some options which they moved in some other options, but the all options are available there. Like for developer toolbar, you need to go in customize ribbon, so you can check and check the developer toolbar. Okay. So as you can see on my Excel, the background is blue. So it is the color scheme of Excel. If you want to change it, you can change it from here. Go to Excel options. You have color scheme. Three types of color scheme you have. One is blue, silver, black. So you can choose anything. And when you press OK, So it will change your Excel color scheme. Or if it is changed by mistake, you can make it correct. Okay. Then you have another option there. Screen tip styles. In screen tip styles, there are three options. Show feature description in screen tip. Don't show feature description in screen tip, and don't show screen tip. So if your screen tip is not showing shortcuts and not showing the descriptions, you can choose the option from there. Screen tip style. Okay. Then you can see my Excel, there are six sheets. Okay. But by default, in every version of Excel, you get three sheets. And if you see my default font, it is Arial and 12. Your maybe Calibri 11 or 10. So you can set your default font here. Default font and how many sheets do you want there. In starting, when you press Control N or you select a new worksheet, so you have option to set this default. In Excel options, you can set your fonts, default font, font size, which view you want to select. There are three views: normal view, page break, preview, page layout view. So you can choose the default view. How many sheets you want there? So you can enter here, include this many sheets. So how many sheets type, like I type here 5 sheets and I press OK. When I press Control N, so I will get a window with 5 sheets. Okay, with that defaults. So we can set our defaults here. Now there is one more option, like edit custom list. This option in 2013 is in advanced. It is in advanced tab. So edit custom list, what are the custom list exactly? Such as if I type any name.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, sir.
Sorry for joining you.
We were just discussing about customization and shortcuts. It was a very less session happened on shortcut. So
I did watch it on YouTube, right?
Yes. The upper time, 10 or 15 minutes, you can watch on YouTube. Rest you can understand with me now as well.
Okay, so you just send it to me on YouTube, right? I'll watch it and get it to you.
Yes. I will send you, and tomorrow we will start on right time, okay? Because
but I'm still watching what you're doing, no problem.
Yes. Because we are a group and we have to run on time. You know? Okay. So I was saying that So I was talking about custom list. So what are the custom list? As you can see, I have typed names and I am dragging it. You can see more names here. Ma'am, are you seeing that? The name which I drag? Hello?
Hello?
Ma'am, are you able to see the names?
Yeah, some names there.
Yes. So I want to tell you that these names are, I have dragged. I've just typed one name and just dragged it, and there are several names also. Because we can drag whatever is in the list of custom list. This is happened due to custom list. So we mostly drag January, February, Sunday, Monday, like this. When you go to this edit custom list option, you can see those lists here. Like you have Sunday, Monday, January, February, and some custom which I have added here. Okay, so I can add the entries here, or I can import the entries from somewhere. Like I need entries from there, so I can select this and add the entries here. So after adding the entry, whatever will be there, it will be dragged. Like I type Delhi and I drag it, so there are lot of city names also, if you are able to see that. Okay, so you can add some of your custom list which you usually use in custom list.
Okay.
Now let's go it further.
How to get?
Yes, ma'am.
How to get this custom?
Just it is in your Excel option, edit custom list.
Okay,
this one, this edit custom list option you have in popular tab.
You can import
something. You can let me import something. Let me type something, some values like yes, ma'am. Let me type something like some products, TV, VCR, bag, wire, like this. So let's suppose these four I want to add in custom list. Okay, I want to import them. So I will go to custom list. I click on the custom list, and then I have import this on the left side of import I have this arrow sign. I will click on that. I will select the values from there, and then this arrow sign I will click again. Then I will press import button. So this will be imported into my list entries, which I can see in list entries here. So I will press add button, and then I will press OK, and then OK to popular tab also. So next time when I type any of the value of them, I can drag them down. Okay, it will be repeated again. Okay. Is it clear, ma'am?
There also I'm facing very disturbance. I can't.
Huh? What, ma'am?
Your voice is coming some. Voice is coming somewhat fast, and the screen is a bit slow.
So what I do, I stop this session here. We will continue it tomorrow. Okay. So till then, I hope I will resolve the problem also. Okay, ma'am.